Hey guys, my name is Koushik and welcome back to LetCode. So far in our Protractor tutorial, we have written so many script file and almost each and every time we execute our test script in sequential. It's not even sequential, we execute our test script in independently each and every file. Today, we are going to learn how to run our test script, multiple test script in sequential as well as in parallel. I'm going to create a new file called conf.js. We are not going to touch this because this is mostly we used for that plugin run protector, but we are going to create a new conf here. So I can just get conf.js. And within this, I'm just going to copy all the code here. And here we'll pasting this. And of course we don't need this. So I'm just going to clean up a little bit here. That's it. Now let us understand how to run our test script in sequential. So even if it's sequential or the parallel, if you compare with TestNG or Java or C#, any other programming language or any unit testing framework, of course we have to write so many things and we have to configure how the driver is going to be shared. But in terms of Protractor, it is going to be very, very simple. Just we have to specify two attributes and that's gonna do the job for us. So first, what are the specs files we have within this particular actions folder? We are going to run all the files in sequential. So let us see how to do that. So first I'm going to specify the folder name. That's going to be our actions. And then followed by, if you see here, we have this pattern called like file names, then followed by dot spec, then followed by dot js. So I'm just going to identify pattern and here I can give that. Of course, I can write each an individual file name within this array, but that's gonna take time. So I'm just going to use the shortcut here. So here I will say star, that means anything, and then dot spec dot js. So here we are targeting all the spec file within this actions folder. Now, if I go back to my terminal and here I'm going to say protector, then followed by conf.js. Now that's it, you can see that each and every file within that particular folder is going to run each files one by one. So here first our this context menu. So this context menu file is executing and after that it's going to execute this drag and drop. And similarly, all the files are going to be executed one by one. So draggable is completed and after that it should perform the mouse over. Okay, so we can see that we got 5 specs run successfully within 42 seconds and of course there is no failure. So in this way we can of course achieve the sequential execution very easily using Protractor. Let us understand how to run in parallel. So I'm not going to take all the test script. I'm just going to take the first two script and within the script, I just added a sleep here and after all a sleep so that we can see that both are running in the parallel. I mean, both script are running in different browsers or else it's going to close it very quickly. So that's the reason I added sleep, nothing other than that. So if I go back to my conf file and here we have to first specify the file names. What are the file names we want to specify? So here we'll see like actions then followed by this file name. So I'm just going to hit F2 and I will copy the name and I will paste it here. Then followed by .js. Similarly, comma, then followed by another file name. So that's going to be this droppable. So I'm just going to copy the relative path and paste over here. And just change this slash to this forward slash. That's it. So within our spec, within this array, we have two spec file now. Now, of course, to run this in parallel, I have to specify two values. That's going to be shared test file. So this is the first value. So I'm just going to copy this and here I will say true. So by default, the value is false. To make our test script in the parallel, we have to make this as true. And then followed by, we have to say the maximum instances. And here I'm going to specify two. So I want to run two browsers at the same time. So that means if you don't specify max instances, what will happen means the default value of max instance is one. That means only one browser is going to launch at the time. But if you want to run in parallel, of course, we have to make our max instances 2 or 3 like that. Now, the number, based on the number, it's going to trigger our browsers at the same time. Okay, so it is same like your thread count in your TestNG XML. Now, I'm just going to terminal and I'm going to run this. So here we can see that we are able to get 2 browsers at the same time and both are loading in different context, I mean different browsers. So here my draggable script is running and here my context menu script is running. So in this way we can achieve the parallel execution very easily without writing so many codes. If you notice, we didn't touch anything in our script except the adding of thread.sleep, I mean browser.sleep. So two things we have to do. One is this add test file. So that means it is going to run our spec file by different files. And then this max instance, we have to configure how many browsers we have to open at the same time. And that's it. We are done with this. And if you want to know more about it, you can just check out this particular documentation or the spec file. The config file from the Protractor. So I will leave a link in the description. You can check it out. And the documentation is very neat and clean, and of course you can understand based on this. So if you have any other queries, we can check it out. In the next video, we will see also how to run our test script in parallel for different browsers. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one very soon.